So thank you very much for coming out tonight, being with us. I hope you enjoy what you hear, and we'll start.
quick word about the top prey variations. So, and I'll try not to spray, but perhaps you might hear me more clearly. So if we were to take someone else's work and make some variation on it, nowadays we would be in violation of copyright, perhaps. If you were in the 18th century, taking someone else's work and making some variations is the ultimate form of flattery. That's what Tapré did with this piece. So the Sauvage is from originally by Jean-Philippe Rameau, from a slightly earlier period in the Baroque, and Tapré came along a little bit later, loved this piece so much that he wrote four variations on this tune. And you might surmise from the title, Sauvage, what we're talking about are Rameau's idea of what savage culture might look like. So the piece is evocative of this scene of an exotic flair. So perhaps we could understand it, or at least I would offer this to you as a way of guiding your listening. Are you familiar with the children's book, Where the Wild Things Are, by Maurice Sendak? This paints kind of a picture of that in my mind, so we'll let the wild rumpus start.
Thank you. not even this pretty severe pinky injury that I incurred last night. Yes, that's right, I haven't been performing for 7 months, yet the night before, I sliced into my left pinky with a kitchen knife. So if that's not a sign that things could be worse, I don't know what it is. I also think it is a sign that musicians are resilient. And we are all so full of gratitude to be here playing for each time.
Thank you. being a directional instrument, I've got to do some weird things here, so bear with me for a second. I'm going to pull myself over here a little bit more. All right. Hi. My name is Dr. Katie Halbert. I may be the newest faculty member here at Grandview in our music program. I am the director of instrumental activities. And that's just a very fancy way of I get to work with the Grandview Wind Ensemble, which is a real treat and delight. And I also teach all the brass instruments at our school, which is really great. So, it is weird to be up here the first time in a few months. The work I'm going to perform for you tonight is actually a work that I am very, very excited about. It is called Shadow Dancer by a woman named Annette Lesiege. And this may or may not be one of the first times it's been performed live in a long time. I worked on my dissertation this last spring, and it was all about works for horn and piano by women composers. And I had to dive very deep to find some works that were tremendous and overlooked in our repertoire in the horn canon. And I stumbled upon this over the summer and was really just very tickled by it. Couldn't use it in my dissertation because it's unaccompanied, but it is a beautiful work. And so by the name Shadow Dancer, what you're going to hear are two very different characters. You're going to hear one that kind of depicts the light side, and then one that kind of more depicts the dark side. And then along with that, you're actually going to hear some extended technique from the instrument, something called stopped horn. So regular horn, stopped horn. A really nice sizzle and a really nice color. It won't always be aggressive. Sometimes it'll just be a shadow of a color. Yeah, see what I did there? But sometimes it will be a little bit aggressive. So try to think about the amount of color and contrast that you hear in this work, and it should help guide you through. Thank you very much.
Thank you. were like gliding over
the. I was very nervous.
Not even as bad as I thought it was.
Have you not done that?